question that we are discussing here, that you can know that ketone contains 4 carbon atoms. Most appropriate reagent for converting butanone to propionic acid. Butanone, you know, CH3, CH2, CO, CH3. How to convert this into propionic acid? CH3, CH3, COH. If you make use of acidic potassium permanganate, the oxidation takes place to give you that the ketone it will give the compound, formic, propionic acid and also ethanoic acid. Tollens reagent is a reaction to give you only RDF. RDF will undergo oxidation reaction. This is not the RDF game, but it's not used to. Whereas alkane came on the floor. Again, it behaves like acidic potassium permanganate, like potassium. Therefore, the compound will give you, along with the propionic acid, you will get the ethanoic acid, also you get the mixture. Whereas here, if it is treated with NaOCl, that is, this is called as what type of reaction? NaOH plus Cl2, halocomb reaction. When this is subjected for halocomb reaction, what happens here is CS3, CS2, CO, CS3, this will undergo halocomb reaction, NaOCl, to give you propionic acid, ONA. This will convert into CHCl3, 4 points of S, and you will get CH2CH2, COONA. Which on further acidification, you are getting the propionic acid. So the most current method of operation is the basic NaOCl. Okay. We are having a molecular formula C4HAO undergoes following reactions to give X and Y. Identify X and Y. This is aldehyde. Aldehyde, it is C4HAO. Aldehyde, that means it is CH3, CH2, CH2, CHO. This is subjected for aluminium calcium hydroxide, CH3, thrice, CH3, thrice, COL. Aluminium calcium hydroxide, the formula is CH3, CCH3, CH3, O, thrice, AL. This is a reagent which will convert the aldehyde into, this is called a station co-reaction. You are getting here the compound, acid and alcohol. This reaction is called a station co-reaction. The station co-reaction is just similar to that of the Kennedy-Zeros reaction. And the Kennedy-Zeros reaction, you know, it will give you acid and alcohol. Whereas here the acid and alcohol form, interact reacting to give you ester, and that ester will undergo hydrolysis to give you acid and alcohol. So this is the modification of Kennedy-Zeros reaction, which is called as station co-reaction. What happens here is this will react, which you know, on treating with this aldehyde with the aluminium tertiary butoxide, it will give you CH3. CH2, CH2, CO, OH is obtained, and this will convert to another alcohol metal, and that alcohol and here it will react to give you O, CO, CH2, 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 CH3. It is butyl, butanoic acid, butanoate. Butyl butanoate, it will give you ester, and this on further hydrolysis, S3O, hydrolysis, it will give CH3, CH2, CH2, COOH, plus CH3, CH2, OH. So this is, so this is butyl butoate. This is butyric acid and this is beta form. Therefore, this is butyl butanoate ester. Butyl butanoate. And this will undergo hydrolysis to give the acid and alcohol. You know the aldehydes which do not contain the alpha hydroatom will undergo Kennison-Roth reaction. This is a modification of Kennison-Roth reaction. Any aldehyde, that means not only this aldehyde, any aldehyde, when it is treated with the aluminum tritium butoxide, it will undergo the reaction which is called a Shishenko reaction, and aldehyde will convert into alcohol and acid. Alcohol and acid cannot be separated, you will get the ester. So this is the butyl butanoate. And this butyl butanoate on further hydrolysis will give you butanoate acid and butyl. That is, the option is D. No reaction. Now here, this is subjected for series of reaction. What is this compound? Can it be? So, you are getting the halopomp reaction. What happens here in the halopomp reaction? This CH3 converts into CCl3 by the action of the bromophore. It is you are getting the compound like that. COCl3. So this CH3, all these hydroatoms are replaced by bromine and you are getting COCBr3, and this on treating further with the sodium hydroxide. It will undergo the reaction to give you ON here and H here. And therefore it will give you the bromoform CHBr3 plus you will get CONA. And this on further acidification, S3O is this. S3O. On acidification, the sodium salt which is obtained there converts into acid. Bromoform is obtained. So this is beta ketonic acid. Beta CO group in the beta process as a keto group. Therefore, this is beta keto acid. Beta keto acid very easily undergo. Remember, the beta keto acid on heating will undergo decarboxylation. And therefore, you get now cyclopentanone. CO is removed. And you are getting cyclopentanone. The option is A. Is that clear? So this particular reaction involves the halopomp reaction, bromopomp reaction, then followed by acid hydrolysis, followed by heating. So that is the product obtained. Okay. This is, what is the name of this compound? 1,2-dimethylcyclopentene. The reaction is carrying out this. Dilute potassium permanganate followed by HiO4. What happens when the alkene is subjected to dilute potassium permanganate? You are getting there OH group. Look here. C double bond C which is there. Suppose the compound is like this. When it is treated with dilute potassium permanganate, Mayer's reagent, you have studied in PUC first year, Mayer's reagent, potassium permanganate supplies oxygen, of course with dilute potassium permanganate, it reacts with H2O to give you two OH groups. So the first reaction, when it is treated with dilute potassium permanganate, the compound will convert into dione. The double bond opens up. OH is formed there. OH is formed there. CH3 remains as it is. Okay? Then when it is treated with HiO4, iodic acid, HiO4 is a characteristic reaction where the diol undergoes breaking. HiO4 is an oxidizing agent, the diol will undergo breaking. And the secondary alkyl, this is secondary alkyl, CH3H, and so tertiary alkyl, CH3, this C, and it has no hydrogen. Therefore, it is tertiary alcohol. And this tertiary alcohol will give you, first it will give you the compound CH2, CO, CH3, CH2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this. Okay? Or you can write it this way. Now imagine what reaction takes place. It is diketonic group having alpha hydrogen. This is a ketonic group having alpha hydrogen. Carbon with alpha hydrogen. Ketone, carbon, alpha hydrogen. Internal aldol condensation takes place. Internal aldol condensation takes place. That means you are getting CH2. This converts COH. CH2, 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 CH. Okay? Now here it is CO. CH2CO, CH3CO, so out of CH3 one H has gone here, CH2OH, CH2CO, CH2, CH3, CH2, and this coefficient is OH. This is the aldol condensation, that is beta hydroxy ketone, this is ketonic group, alpha beta carbon. So the beta carbon has got the hydroxyl group. Therefore, it is beta hydroxy ketone. Or you can say the ketone, aldol bond is ketone carry group. And this on heating will undergo water molecule zero. That is, H here, OH here. Suppress out. Don't confuse. OH here, H here, all the. EH reactor. That here, no, no. Why only this H? This OH cannot be also removed from this. But this H will not react. This H is there. Why? Because next to it there is a CO group. This CO group makes this H acidic. So don't confuse. Beta elimination takes place. So this OH will not react here. It will react with this. Why it will react with this? Because of the presence of CO group. This H is activated. and therefore water separates and you are getting there CH2CO, CH, double bond CCH3, CH2, CH2, this one, alpha beta unsaturated ketone. So this is the compound and you are getting here only compound there, the 1, 2, A, B, C or D, it is C, after B. CO of that, CO group is alpha, beta. This is alpha, beta. This is alpha, this is beta. So, you have got the unsaturated ketone. Reaction. Aldehyde reacted with methyl cyanide. Methyl cyanide, dicyanomethane. CN is cyanogroup. Dicyanomethane. This reacts in presence of base, C5H5N, that is, reading is a base, and followed by dilutase here, followed by ketone. What happens here? CH2 is an active methionine group. CH2 is active methionine group because this N draws electron. And therefore, these hydrogen becomes active. Yesterday, I think you have studied, if there is a CH group in between the CO group, 2CO group, this is called as active methionine group. Similarly, here it is also active methionine group. And this active methionine group, CH2, CN2, in presence of its base, it separates CH, CN, right. So what the question asked is, which of these statements are about the reaction, are true about the reaction? Formation of intermediate CH, CN twice. So CH, CN twice is obtained here. So formation of intermediate CH and use alpha, beta, unsaturated acid. Let us see what happens further. So first thing is, it has found this and this up. Well, this will further react with aldehyde. CH2O reacts with CH2 CN twice. This CH will go over there, that is one of the hydrogen atom separates out forming CH CN cation. Now this CH goes there, here what happens here? Get OH. Yes. And this C which has got a negative charge. When this is shifted here, this will get negative charge, this gets positive charge. So one of the H which is positive in nature goes there to give you OH. Okay? And this can positive charge. And this positive charge attached to this negative charge. Therefore, what you get is CH OH, CH, CN. This is the action product which is formed here. Aldehyde will react with the dicyanomethane to give you the addition product. Okay? That is, this H goes over there, OH end, and this negative charge carbon atom connects to this carbon, therefore CH, CN2. This is further subjected for hydrolysis. Hydrolysis, what happens? Cyano group will undergo hydrolysis to give you COOH. Cyanide group, understand? The cyano group will undergo hydrolysis. That means it will add a molecule of water and you are getting CONH2. Amide. And this amide further undergoes oxidation hydrolysis. Ammonia separates out, plus you get COOH. So that is how the cyanide group will turn into COOH group. There are two cyanide groups. What happens? You are getting two CO2. That one, when it is subjected for HCl, you are getting this one. CH, OH, CH, COOH, COOH. The two CN groups which are present there convert to CO2. Okay? And this is a dicarboxylic state. This dicarboxylic state will undergo very easily the dehydration. And by heating, it will remove molecule of water and also remove molecule of carbon dioxide. Two CO2 groups are there on the same carbon atom. And such compounds are unstable in the undergo liberation of water, carbon dioxide. So CO2 is lost. And then this OH, this H, is also removed on heating. Therefore, you are getting alpha beta unsaturated acid. So, there are four options. First one is formation of the intermediate CH minus CN dash, and it gives alpha beta unsaturated acid. You are getting alpha beta unsaturated. This is the concentrate, this is alpha, this is beta. In the common method. So, alpha beta unsaturated acid. So, formation of intermediate CH-CN dash and gives alpha hydroxy dicarboxylic. Alpha hydroxy dicarboxylic acid. This dicarboxylic acid on heating will remove a molecule of water, carbon dioxide, and also water. So this answer is half, complete reaction again. Heat model one. Heat model again I think. So that is. Therefore, B is wrong, C is also wrong, D is also wrong. Amine you are not getting amine. Formation of C is formation of intermediate CHCl. And for benzoic acid. Benzoic acid formula. Then we are telling alpha beta acidic. So this is also an important reaction. Please remember. Okay? Now the question is metachlorobenzaldehyde on reaction with concentrated KOH at room temperature gives metachloro, nothing to do with the chloro, their reaction is the characteristic reaction of the benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde, you know, does not contain alpha hydrogen atoms. There is a chloro group present here. It has nothing to do with the aldehyde reaction. So when this is treated with concentrated solution of KOH, this compound will undergo Kenney-Sarov's reaction. Kenney-Sarov reaction, that is the aldehyde which is not having alpha hydrogen atom, will undergo Kenney-Sarov reaction. This is aldehyde which does not have the alpha hydrogen atom. And therefore, the Kenney-Sarov reaction takes place. It is just in meta position, let it be there. So, this will be giving you chlorine is there, CHO group will convert into COONA. And another benzaldehyde converts into alcohol. That is oxidation reduction. Therefore, the option is potassium M chlorobenzoate and metahydroxybenzaldehyde. Metahydroxybenzaldehyde. Then metahydroxybenzaldehyde and metachlorobenzoic acid. Again, metabenzoxaldehyde is not obvious. Metachlorobenzyl alcohol and metahydroxybenzyl benzoate. Now, chloro group will not undergo any hydroxylation. Therefore, metahydroxy is wrong. That is metachloro potassium benzoate and metachlorobenzyl alcohol. Since you have treated with potassium hydroxide, you are getting this one. COK, that is metachloro potassium benzoate, and this is metachloro benzyl alcohol. So this is the reaction, simple reaction. So the question answer is T. Well, next is the most reactive compound towards the formation of cyanohydrin on treatment with KCl followed by acidification is. This is a simple reaction where he is asking you the reactivity of the CHO group. The most reactive compound towards the formation of cyanohydrin with KCl followed by acidification. Benzaldehyde, para-nitro-benzaldehyde, phenyl acetaldehyde, para-hydroxybenzaldehyde. Now remember, this is a property of aldehyde. This aldehyde, when it is treated with KCN and acidification, this will give you HCN. This HCN undergoes reaction here. KCN and acidification will give HCN. This HCN will react here. What you are getting there? Cyanohydrin. How it gives cyanohydrin? Because oxygen being more electronegative, plus the electron, this becomes O negative, this becomes positive. Therefore, what happens here? H positive, Cn minus. What do you get there? OH, cyanohydrin are getting. CH, Cn, OH. This is a cyanohydrin, which is a property of the aldehyde. Aldehyde has no reaction that's here to give you cyanohydrin. Now, what he is asking is, if there is different group there, benzaldehyde or para-nitro-benzaldehyde, suppose the nitro group is there, or phenyl acetaldehyde. This is phenyl acetaldehyde. It is not the aromatic aldehyde, remember. Phenyl acetaldehyde. Now here, out of this, whether the benzaldehyde react easily, or nitrobenzaldehyde react easily, or this one. Let us look here. If the NO2 group is present in the para position, NO2 group is an electron withdrawing group. When the electron withdrawing group is there, the positive charge, that means this becomes more stable. Positive charge is here, electron withdrawing group, and therefore this carbon attains more positive charge. Electrophilicity of the carbon increases. Electrophilicity means property of reacting with Cn, increase negative charge. So, NO2 group which is present makes this carbon of the carbonyl group more electrophilicity. That means it will get little more positive charge. And this carbon becomes more positively charged and Cn will attack very easily. Therefore, out of the four compounds, which will react very easily with the Cn there? It must be nitro group. If it is para-nitro, the para-nitro group which is there, this will increase the electrophilicity of this and therefore it will react very easily. So, in this question, the question of electrophilicity comes and the NO2 group will help the electrophilicity of the carbon. Hence, it will increase that. Benzaldehyde will react, but this benzaldehyde will be less reactive than that of the nitro group. Therefore, nitrobenzaldehyde is more reactive, right? So this is the answer for this one. Therefore, the answer is P. Benzaldehyde, nitro group makes the electrophilicity of the carbon more. Okay. Ketone reacts with magnesium, mercury alloy and water to give. This is bimolecular reduction of ketone. Bimolecular reduction of ketone. Other example, let us take CH3. C double bond 4, CH3. This two molecules of this will react in presence of magnesium, mercury, alloy, and water. Reduction takes place and you will get different forms. CH3, CCH3, O converts into OH. This O converts into OH and this carbon connects to another ketone where this is called a bimolecular reduction. It can be written like this also. CH3, C double bond O, CH3, C double bond O, CH3, CH3. This will react with 2H, you write it here. And this will turn into H, this also turn into H, and this carbon are connected. So you are getting this one. So this compound is called as pinaco. So any ketone, say for example, CH2, CO, CH3, two molecules will react. And you are getting CH2, COH, H, CH2, OH, CH2. So such compounds are called as pinacol and pinacols. So the compound part is pinacol. Okay? Not pinacolone. Pinacolone is different. Pinacolone is this. Where are you getting the pinacol? This is pinacolone. Pinacol on P2-PET acid, it will rearrange itself to pinacolone. So this is called a pinacol, pinacolone rearrangement. So the pinacol is not of it. Suppose the question is like that. Ketones react with magnesium and mercury alloy and treated water followed by acid, followed by acid and tantra, pinacol converts into pinacol. So that would have been correct. And there you are not getting pinacol. Pinacol is obtained when the pinacol is treated with acid. And this is a rearrangement taking place. So that is called as pinacolone. This is pinacolone. And you are not getting pinacolone, but it is pinacol. This is the pinacol. So the correct answer is B. Conversion of phenyl diazole to 2-hydroxyphenylethanol is an example of. Let us see what is phenyl diazole. Phenyl diazole is this. CHO. Phenyl diazole is 1H is equal to 3H. So pH. CO, CHO. This is phenyl diazole. This is glyoxal. This is glyoxal. H is replaced by phenyl group. So this is phenyl glyoxal. This phenyl glyoxal, it has to be converted into 2-hydroxyphenylethanol. Ethanol is this. This is ethanol. 2-hydroxy-2-phenyl. That means the second carbon has got OH up here and it has got OH up here. It's a pinacolone. So how can you convert this one? That is CHO is converted into CH2OH and therefore and this is CO is converted to alcohol and this is example of self-oxidation. Now self-oxidation. Self-oxidation takes place, it will give you acid. Aldol condensation, no aldol condensation because it has no alpha-hydrogen atoms. Alpha-hydrogen atoms with aldol condensation. Internal cross-Kennedy-Jones reaction and auto-reduction. It is not auto-reduction, self-oxidation. This is internal cross-Kennedy-Jones reaction. because the aldehyde does not contain alpha hydrogen atom. So aldehyde is not containing alpha hydrogen atom, therefore it doesn't give an internal cross-kinase oscillation. Okay? So the correct answer is internal cross-kinase oscillation. Okay. Select the least reactive carbonyl compound for nucleophilic action. Benzophenone, acetophenone, acetaldehyde, benzoic acid. Here, A, B, and C, they will undergo nucleophilic action reaction. That is, ketone, again, the carbonyl groups will undergo nucleophilic action reaction. So, what are the different ketone carbon there? Benzophenone is this. Acetophenone is this. Knowing the name of the compound, you must immediately guess what is the structure. Benzaldehyde is simple. C6H5, CN2. Benzoic acid, C6H5. This is out of question. Because this will not undergo nucleophilic action reaction. When you think it, you have to consider about a thing. Now remember, here the CO group is not hindered at all. CO group is not hindered. Here it is hindered, here it is more hindered. So the CO group is not exposed for the reaction because of the bulkier phenyl groups. Therefore, the CO group is not reactive. Select the least reactive carbonyl compound. Most reactive is benzaldehyde, least reactive is benzophenone. Because in case of benzaldehyde, the CO group is not hindered much. Whereas HCHO, this is highly reactive. CH3CHO, this is also reactive. Because the carbon group is exposed. Whereas here, the carbon group is little hindered. Here, the carbon group is more hindered. Therefore, least reactive is benzophenone. Okay? Observe the reactions given and identify X and Y. What is X? What is Y? Now, if you remember, starting from the aldehyde, this is not affected here. In the product, this is not affected. So, it remains as it is. What is going to affect the aldehyde? CHO group is connected to alpha beta unsaturated acid. Remember, this is a property of Parkinson's reaction. What is Parkinson's reaction? Aromatic aldehydes react with acetic anhydride CH3CO2SO in presence of sodium salt of the same acid, sodium acetate. Where alpha hydrogen atoms are involved in this reaction and one H goes there and you are getting the alpha hydroxy acid and further it will remove water of bottle of water and get alpha hydroxy acid. You have studied this, is a Parkinson's reaction. The other day I had told you what is Parkinson's reaction. So here instead of acetaldehyde you are taking propionic anhydride. It has come CH2, CO, twice, O. So propionic anhydride in presence of which salt? Sodium propionate. If you take acetic acid here, you should take sodium acetate. If you take propionic acid, propionic anhydride, you should take the sodium propionate. If you take butanic anhydride, you should take the sodium butanate. So, the sodium salt of the same acid should be taken. And here, what happens? Alpha hydrogen atoms are involved. Therefore, you are getting ARCHOH of the alpha hydrogen atom. This is what comes there. And this carbon attached here, CH. CH3 COOH. So we get this, and this dehydration, they are CH3 COOH. What is the product of them there? CH3. They are CH double bond CCH3 COOH. This is what? So to form this one, what are you using there? This one and this one. What is this? Propionic anhydride. Propionic anhydride and sodium propionate. So question is, that is you have found here, propionic anhydride. This is propionic anhydride, sodium propionate. So this is the reaction, that is Parkinson's reaction. Okay. Action. Try to solve remaining questions, and if you got any doubts, any problems, please ask me. Thank you.